गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज वर्क एंड एनर्जी। सो बिफोर न्यूमेरिकल्स देयर इज सम इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल बिलो आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला। So, before numericals, you have to learn all this important formula, okay? So, first one is W is equal to F S cos theta. W is the work done, F is the force, S is the displacement. Cos theta, that is theta. Here, theta is the angle between force and displacement. W is equal to mgh. This formula is used in case of gravitational field. Okay, if you want to find work done in gravitational field, then you have to use W is equal to mgh. It means, say this is marker having mass, some mass. If you lift from the earth till 5 meter, so in this case you have to do the work against gravitational field. So in case if you want to find work done, then work done will be mgh. M is the mass of the marker, g is the acceleration due to gravity, that is 9.8 meter per second square, and h is the height. So if you lift it 5 meters, then you have to use 5 at the place of h. Same, potential energy is equal to mgh. Potential energy, mgh. M is the mass of the object, g is the acceleration due to gravity, h is the height. See, any mass is at the height of 10 meter. In this case, potential energy stored in that object will be equal to mgh. How much potential energy will store in the object? Mgh. M is the mass of the object, g is again acceleration due to gravity, h is the height. Okay. Kinetic energy, that is half mv square. Work done is equal to, here v is the final velocity. V is the final velocity. Again, work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. So therefore, work done, W is equal to change in kinetic energy, means final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. Final kinetic energy, that is m 1 upon 2 mv square minus 1 upon 2 mu square. V is the final velocity, u is the initial velocity. So therefore W is equal to, if you take common 1 upon 2m, if you take common, then in bracket v square minus u square. So therefore W is equal to half m bracket v square minus u square. This is important for the numericals, we will use in the numericals. And this formula 6, P is equal to W upon T. P is electric power, W is equal to work done, T is equal to time. If you put W is equal to mgh, so therefore P will be equal to mgh. In place of W, you have to put mgh upon T. So this is again important. We will use this in your numericals. This is also important for the numericals. N is the number of unit consumed, is equal to PT upon 1000 unit. Remember, in this formula, T is in hour. T is in hour. Understood? So this is important. Here T is in second. But here in this formula, N is equal to PT upon 1000 unit. T in this formula, whenever we will solve the numericals, you have to put time in hour. Okay? So that's why I have written here, time is in hours. So now, come to the numericals, that is
क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव. सॉल्व द फॉलोइंग एग्जांपल्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेक योर टेक्स्ट बुक एंड रीड द क्वेश्चंस एंड फाइंड द गिवन डेटा. सो फर्स्ट न्यूमेरिकल इज एन इलेक्ट्रिक पंप हैज 2 kW पावर. How much water will the pump lift every minute to a height of 10 meter? It means an electric pump has 2 kW power. It means P is given. How much 2 kW? Okay. And how much water will the pump lift? How much water will the pump lift? It means you have to find the value of M. Every minute, that is time is given. Time is how much? Every minute, 1 minute is given. So 1 minute, that is 60 second. To a height of 10 meter. See, units is 10 meter. That is H is equal to, height is equal to how much? 10 meter. So first of all, what you have to do? First of all, we will write given data. Given P is equal to how much? P is equal to 2 kilo means 1000 watt. So P is equal to how much? 2000 watt. Kilo means 1000, so you have to multiply by 1000, so therefore P will be equal to how much? 2000 watt. Lift every minute. Time is equal to how much? Time is equal to 1 minute. That is equal to 1 minute is equal to how many second? 1 into 1 minute is equal to 60 second. So therefore T is equal to 60 second. Remember, whenever we solve the numericals, you have to put everything in SI unit. Okay. So T is equal to how much? 60 second. At the height of 10 meter. H is equal to how much? 10 meter. Given P is equal to 2000 watt. T is equal to 60 second. H is equal to 10 meter. Given. To find. How much water will the pump lift? It means M is equal to mass is equal to mass of the water is equal to question mark. Okay. Given to find. Then formula used. We know that. See, P, T, H is given. And there is M also. So we will use P is equal to M G H upon T. See, P is given, M we have to find, G we know that G is equal to how much? 9.8 meter per second square. That is acceleration due to gravity on the surface of Earth is fixed. That is 9.8 meter per second square. H is given, T is given. So that's why we have to use this formula. Then solution. Since P is equal to MGH upon T, right? So P is equal, we have to find M. So therefore, here is 1. MGH into 1, that is
एम जी एच इक्वल टू पी इंटू टी क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन दैट इज पी टी. सो एम विल बी इक्वल टू पी टी अपॉन जी एच. ओके सो एम विल बी इक्वल टू पी इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच दैट इज 2000 वोट. सो राइट 2000 इंटू टी इज हाउ मच 60. G is equal to how much? G is equal to 9.8. We know that the value of G is equal to how much? 9.8 meter per second square. H is equal to how much? 10. Here you can write here. G is equal to how much? The value of G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. For on the surface of Earth, the value of G is fixed. So if you remove decimal from here, you have to add 0 here. 0 cancel. 30 to the 60. 49 to the 98. That is M is equal to 3 to the 6. 1, 2, 3, 4 upon 49. Okay, so if you solve it, therefore M is equal to how much? It will come 1224.56. See, M is the mass, so its SI unit will be kilogram. So right here, kilogram. Understood? So in language, you can write M is equal to total 1224.5 kilogram water will the pump lift every minute. Okay. Next is fifth B. If 1200 watt electric iron is used daily for 30 minutes. 1200 watt. What is the unit of power? Electric power. Okay. So P is equal to how much? 1200 watt. Understood? Is used daily for 30 minutes. 30 minutes, that is time is equal to how much? 30 minutes. How much total electricity is consumed in the month of April? In the month of April, if an electric iron is used for 30 minutes every day. So in that case, you have to find how many units consumed. It means N is equal to question mark. N is the, where N is the number of unit consumed. Okay. So first of all, write given data. Given. See, 1200 watt. What is the unit of electric power? It means P is given. P is equal to how much? 1200 watt. Understood? Is used for 30 minutes, that is time is equal to 30 minutes. Secondly, we are going to use this formula. N is equal to PT upon 1000 unit, this one. So here I have explained, here T, you have to put T is in hour. Okay, so here 30 minutes is equal to how much hours? So that is 30 minutes is equal to 30 upon 60 hours. 3 1 3 3 2 6. It means time is equal to, therefore time is equal to 1 upon 2, that is 0.5 hours ओके गिवन देन वी हैव टू फाइंड n is equal to question mark n is equal to question mark for the month of April okay formula used n is equal to pt upon 1000 units then solution since that is we know that n is equal to pt upon 1000 units राइट यूनिट एट लास्ट एन इज इक्वल टू पीटी अपॉन 1000 यूनिट्स सो एन इज इक्वल टू पी इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच दैट इज 1200 टी इज इक्वल टू 0.5 आवर्स अपॉन Right here, unit, no problem. Remove decimal from here. That is 10, 1, 2, 1, 2. That is 0, 0 cancel. 5, 1 is 5, 5, 2 is 10. So, n is equal to 12 upon 10 into 2 1 the 2, 2 6 the 12. So n will be 6 upon 10, that is 0.6 units. So n is equal to 0.6 unit. When you used iron for 30 minutes, when you used 30 minutes, then total number of unit consumed is equal to 0.6 units. But we have to find total unit consumed in the month of April. Understood? So therefore, total units. Total units consumed in the month of April is equal to April, how many days? In April, how many days? 30 into in one day total unit consumed 0.6. Remove the point decimal 10 0 0 cancel that is 36 the 18 units therefore total units consumed in April month is equal to 18 units. This is your answer. Understood? Next,
फिफ्थ से इफ द एनर्जी ऑफ अ बॉल फॉलिंग फ्रॉम ए हाइट ऑफ 10 मीटर दैट इज हाइट ऑफ 10 मीटर हाइट इज गिवन दैट इज 10 मीटर इज रिड्यूस्ड बाय 40% से दिस इज रॉन्ग से दिस इज अ बॉल हैविंग मास m ओके मास m एट दिस हाइट हाइट इज गिवन हाउ मच h इज गिवन हियर h इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच 10 मीटर से हियर इज PE पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज हाउ मच 100 जूल बी एज्यूम पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट पॉइंट ए दिस इज से दिस इज पॉइंट ए एट ए दिस इज ग्राउंड सी इफ द एनर्जी ऑफ अ बॉल फॉलिंग फ्रॉम द हाइट ऑफ 10 मीटर इज रिड्यूस्ड बाय 40% इनिशियली एट पॉइंट ए एम इज द मास एट द हाइट ऑफ 10 मीटर फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड बी एज्यूम्ड दैट एट पॉइंट ए पोटेंशियल एनर्जी पी इज इक्वल टू 100 जूल नाउ दिस 100 जूल इज रिड्यूस्ड बाय 40% इट मीन्स नाउ से यर इज एट द हाइट 10 मीटर एनर्जी इज 100 जूल बी एज्यूम्ड एनर्जी इज 100 जूल नाउ सपोज नाउ दिस ऑब्जेक्ट इज हियर हैविंग मास सेम मास एम नाउ से दिस इज पॉइंट बी नाउ इट हैज एनर्जी पीई इज इक्वल टू 40% रिड्यूस्ड 40% हैज रिड्यूस्ड सो नाउ दिस एट पॉइंट बी देयर इज द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज हाउ मच 60 जूल बिकॉज 40% हैज रिड्यूस्ड तो हाउ मच रिमेनिंग एनर्जी इज 100 माइनस 40 दैट इज 60 जूल सो हियर एनर्जी ऑफ द बॉल इज 60 जूल अंडरस्टूड बिकॉज आई हैव टेकन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट पॉइंट ए इज 100 जूल एंड 40% हैज रिड्यूस्ड सो रिमेनिंग एनर्जी इज हाउ मच 60 जूल सो एट दिस टाइम How will it rebound? It means if energy of the ball is 60 joule, then how much this will rebound from the ground surface? So I assumed till h height it will rebound. Okay. So given you can make draw the diagram. Ground here. In given. You can draw the diagram like this, okay? Given. Then to find h is equal to question mark we have to find because how will it rebound? Formula used PE is equal to MGH this formula we will use solution since PE that is potential energy is equal to MGH so potential energy PE at point A PE this potential energy at point A is equal to PE is equal to MGH PE is equal to how much?
पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट पॉइंट ए इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच 100 एम जी एच इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच 10 इक्वेशन नंबर 1. नाउ सेम सिमिलरली पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट पॉइंट बी पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट पॉइंट बी दैट इज पीई इज इक्वल टू एम जी एच सो पी इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच 60 एम जी एच इज इक्वल एट द प्लेस ऑफ एच हियर इज एच सो राइट एच इक्वेशन नंबर 2 डिवाइड इक्वेशन 2y1 और 1y2 डिवाइड इक्वेशन 2y1 सो 2 60 अपॉन 2y1 दैट इज 100 इज इक्वल टू 60 दैट इज एम जी एच अपॉन 100 दैट इज एम जी इंटू 10 एम एम कैंसिल जी जी कैंसिल 00 कैंसिल दैट इज 6 अपॉन 10 इज इक्वल टू एच अपॉन 10 अंडरस्टूड क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन 10 क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन 10 इंटू एच दैट इज 10 एच इज इक्वल टू 6 इंटू 10 दैट इज 60 सो देयर फोर एच इज इक्वल टू 60 अपॉन 10 00 कैंसिल अंडरस्टूड सो देयर फोर एच इज इक्वल टू 6 एच इज द हाइट एंड बी मेजर हाइट इन मीटर बिकॉज ऑल द यूनिट्स वी हैव टेकन इन एसआई सिस्टम सो द हाइट ऑफ द एच विल बी इक्वल टू 6 मीटर सो द बॉल विल रिबाउंड हाउ मच 6 मीटर इफ यू रिड्यूस द एनर्जी बाय 40% ओके This is 5th D. The velocity of a car increases from 54 km per hour to 72 km per hour. How much is the work done if the mass of the car is 1500 kg? Okay. So initially, car was moving with the velocity of 54 km per hour. From 54 hour, it became 72 km per hour after some time. So in this process, there must be work done by the engine to increase the velocity from the 54 km per hour to 72 km per hour. So we have to find work done. So you can see here velocity is changing from 54 to 72. So I have explained you, work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. Because here speed is changing, velocity is changing from 54 to 72. So in this numericals we will use work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. Okay. Mass is given, mass of the car is 1500 kilogram. So initially velocity of the car was 54 km per hour and final velocity it became 72 km per hour. Okay. So given U means initial velocity 54 kilometer per hour. See,
Here, initial velocity is 54 kilometer per hour. So from kilometer per hour, you have to change meter per second. Kilometer per hour to meter per second. That is, u is equal to 54 into. If you want to change kilometer per hour to meter per second, then you have to multiply by 5/18. I have explained in the previous lecture. Now you have to write here meter per second, because you have multiplied by 5/18. So write here 5/18 meter per second. Here is kilometer per hour, but here we will write meter per second. 18 when the 18, 18 3 is the 54. So u is equal to how much? 15 meter per second. Now we will use 15 meter per second, not 54 kilometer per hour. Okay, so it became 54 to 72. So v is equal to how much? That is 72 kilometer per hour. Here is kilometer per hour. So again, 72 into 5/18. Here we will use meter per second, because you have multiplied by 5/18. 18 1 the 18 4 the. So v is equal to how much? 20 meter per second. So we will use v at the place of v, 20 meter per second, and at the place of u we will use 15 meter per second. And also mass is given. Mass of the car is equal to how much? 1500 kilogram is given. Given to find, given to find work done. Work done is equal to question mark, formula used. Work done is equal to change in kinetic energy, that is 1/2 m v square minus e square. This formula we are going to use. Solution: since work done is equal to 1/2 m v square minus u square, so work done is equal to 1/2 into, at the place of m, that is 1500 v square, v is 20. 20 square, that is 400, minus u square, u is 15, 15 square, that is 225. W is equal to 1/2 into, see, 2 1 the 2, here will be 750. So here 750 bracket 4 minus 0, 10 minus 5, that is 571. So if you will multiply this, you will get how much? This is 1, that is 750 into 175, that is 131250. Work done. The A unit of work is joule. So right here, joule. Therefore, W is equal to 131250 joule. So this much work will done the engine to increase the velocity of 54 km per hour to 72 km per hour. Okay? So in the language, you will write here, the work done is equal to 131250 joule to increase the velocity from 54 km per hour to 72 km per hour. You have to write in the language, okay? fifth E, that is the last number in class of chapter number 2, work and energy. Okay. So first of all, read the questions. Where we applied a force of 10 Newton. 10 Newton. Newton is the unit of force. So that is F is equal to 10 Newton is given. To move a block of 30 centimeter. Centimeter is distance. Distance is equal to how much? 30 centimeter. In the direction of force. It means what? If I draw a diagram, so this is mass M and Ravi is applying a force of how much? 10 Newton on this mass. Due to this 10 Newton, this block, this book, say this is book. This is a book. Due to 10 Newton, this book moved how much? 3 centimeter. Okay, 3 centimeter. Due to this 10 Newton force, this book moved or displaced a distance by 3 centimeter. How much was the work done by the Ravi? So the work done, there will be some work done by the Ravi. So that work done you have to find. So right here given F is equal to how much? 10 Newton. Displacement. Your displacement is 3 centimeter. So displacement is 3 centimeter. So you have to convert centimeter into meter because we have to use SI unit. The SI unit of displacement or distance is meter. So this will be equal to 3 upon 100 meter. So this will be equal to 120. So this will be equal to 0.03 meter. Okay. So now this we have to use in the formula. Given, then to find. Work done is equal to question mark formula used. See, F is given, S is given. So, in which formula F and S and W comes? So that is W is equal to FS cos theta. Okay, this formula we are going to use. Solution. W is equal to F is equal to how much? 10. S is equal to how much? 0.03. Cos C. In this case, theta is equal to how much? Force is in this direction. Direction of force. And displacement is in same direction. So here angle between force and displacement is zero, because in the previous lecture I have explained you, if the direction of force and displacement both are in same direction, in that case theta, where theta is the angle between force and displacement, is zero. So therefore W is equal to, remove decimals from here will be 100. So 10 into 3 upon 100, 0 0 cancel, cos 0 that is 1. So right here
सेंस कॉस जीरो जीरो इज इक्वल टू वन. सो डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू थ्री अपॉन टेन. सो देयर फोर डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू थ्री अपॉन टेन दैट इज 0.3 जूल बिकॉज द ए साइन यूनिट ऑफ वर्क इज जूल. सो इन द लैंग्वेज यू हैव टू राइट द वर्क डन बाय 10 न्यूटन फोर्स इज इक्वल टू 0.3 जूल. इफ यू डोंट राइट इन द लैंग्वेज योर हाफ मार्क्स विल बी डिडक्टेड. ओके सो राइट हियर द वर्क डन बाय 10 न्यूटन फोर्स इज इक्वल टू 0.3 जूल दैट इज आंसर. जस्ट अ सेकेंड. F is equal to answer is given 3 joule. Just a second. F is equal to 10 newton. C. Your displacement is not 3 centimeter. Displacement is 30 centimeter. Sorry. 30 centimeter. So 30 upon. Just a second. 30 centimeter. So 30 upon 100 meter. That is. 00 कैंसिल 0.3 मीटर डिस्प्लेसमेंट विल बी इक्वल टू 0.3 मीटर. सो राइट हियर नॉट 0.03 दैट इज हियर विल बी ओनली 0.3. एफ 10 इज 0.3 इनटू कॉस थीटा. ओके हियर विल बी 10. Just a second. So W is equal to 10 into, if you remove decimal from here, it will be 10. So 3 upon 10, 10, 10 cancel. Cos 0 is equal to 1. So W is equal to 3 into 1, 3. The A side unit of work is joule. 3 joule, okay? So the work done by the work done by 10 Newton force is equal to 3 joule. Okay, this is the answer. So in the next lecture, we will start chapter number 3, that is current electricity. Thank you.